Hi guys, this is Jamie from System22 and greatwebdesign.com and welcome to this video. I had a question the other day. Somebody asked me if you could do a CSS hover effect and make a square turn into a hexagon. Let's have a look here. We've got a nice square image here. Well, of course the answer is yes. We've got a nice square image here and we'll try and get this to turn into a hexagon when we hover over it. We can make this work. There is one drawback though. This will not work with Internet Explorer, which is now pretty much redundant, and the new Microsoft Edge. Edge will be having support for it apparently in the future, but at the moment it doesn't. When you're watching this video, hopefully they would have updated that. So anyway, I'm going to show you how to do it. So we're going to work on this picture right here, and this does, obviously it will work on any shape, but it does work better on something that's square. So here's our image, and the CSS code we actually want is what they call a clip path code, and rather than write it all out here, I've got it. And as with many things, I'll put it in a PDF that you can download underneath this video so you don't have to copy what I'm doing on screen and just adjust it to your needs. So let's go into this module here. We go to the edit page. It's this image right here, I believe. Yep, that's it. Okay, and I'm using the Divi theme here. Divi's absolutely awesome. I'll put a link if anybody wants to get it down below there. If you're a WordPress developer, it's pretty much the only theme you need. I've used it on all kinds of projects and it just keeps getting better. But anyway, enough of the sales talk. I'm going to the Advanced tab. I'm going to give it a class. I'll just call it Fireworks. Obviously, you call yours whatever you want to. There's that image there. Here's the actual code I'm going to put into our custom CSS. I've already got it pre-written over here on a little text pad. And it looks like a bunch of mumbo jumbo, but this is the actual polygon sides. And it's telling it how to build this shape, the CSS. So I'm just going to copy this. And as I say, this will be in a PDF under the video. Please download it and use it however you wish. Now I'm going to go to our theme options, which is down the bottom, Divi, theme options, and two. If you scroll down to the bottom of the page, there's our custom CSS tab. Now, make myself a bit of space. I'll put it just above my remove bottom bar, I think, because it's sort of going down in the order that I've done things to this site. I'll give it a title. For those of you that haven't watched my videos before, I always give my CSS individual elements a title so that if I want to go back and edit them later, I can find them a lot easier. So I'll just call this X Hex CSX. Actually, Hex Hover, I think. There we go. Now then, we just called that element fire, so I'm going to put dot fire. Open and close some curly brackets. Drop that second one down a little bit. And in between, I've got to put that clip path code. Now I want to tell it to do it just on the hover, so I put a colon after the fire, and this is really important, no space, no space after the colon, and then I write hover. Okay, so let's save our changes. Go back to our site and do a refresh. Now hopefully when I hover over that should turn it into a hexagon. There you go. So I hope this answers the question, can you turn your square into a hexagon on a hover? And the answer is yes. And of course you can apply that class to any other element you want to. It does work better on square things. For instance, we can put it on there and there, but it would obscure some of this. But if you want to use it as an effect, I'm sure that's fine. Let's go ahead and do that just to show you. So that was that text there. So we just need to give it the class of fire, which is the class we gave to the original. Let's do it on this one as well. It's going to look a bit strange, but I'm just going to show you. Save that. Of course, we want to update our page. And let's scroll down to those elements. Like I say, they all look a bit strange, but I was just doing this to show you can do it on any element, best if it's square. So now when I hover over that frequently asked questions, it should change to a hex. There you go, it kind of obscures half of it, and it's not square, so it's not a proper hex. And let's do it over the accordions over here. There you go. Just to show you, you can do it on any element that you want to do it by just giving it the same class as we've given our original image here. So if you've got a bunch of images or something you want to do that, just give it that class of fire. So there you have it. I hope that's been helpful to you. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. If you've enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel. And you can download this code in the PDF below the video. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.